Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the channel. This is going to be Thunder Ducky. I'm going to be recording some Red Dead Redemption 2 because it appears people like recordings more than they like live streams. And, well, we're just going to hop right into it. This is my first time playing this game. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And, yeah, let's get into it. So, who do we got first? We got Brr. Dutch needs you to ask around in public places for information on Angelo Bronte. Is the camera so far back? I gotta fix my volume. Here we go. Yo, there we go, Arthur. Come on. Gonna do some walking. Well, running. Try to enjoy the streets a little bit. Don't hit me with that trolley. I hate when that just randomly pops up. Depending on who you ask, some women can be monsters.
Should be more people in the world like you. God bless.
Hello, mister. You know a good place? Get some food?
Can you spare some money for a blind man?
Okay, I guess he's just gonna ignore me.
You, mister, excuse me.
Bonjour, please, anything
sure
you can
run into some nice folks out
this
way.
Oh.
And who am I supposed to ask?
Hello, sir.
How do you do?
Did I drop a coin? I know I heard it. Oh, here we are.
Oh. I was going to say, it literally asked for me to ask around for Angela.
Stick 'em up, cowboy.
That's just how it is.
Real funny, Dutch.
Oh, I thought so. So, here we are in a strange land of papists and rapists. America's very own Gomorrah.
This city's all of the same to me. So, how you get on?
I've been asking around about Mr. Bronte. From what I've heard, this establishment is our best lead, but I haven't had any joy in there so far.
So, I should just give it a shot?
I think so. Just keep it cool.
You know me.
I'll meet you back here anon.
What's a hell of a way to walk in?
Funny you should say that.
Well, you know how it is.
Hey, can I get a drink here?
That's the state of Lemoyne for you. America's dirty little French secret.
That's why we love it.
Born and raised.
Excuse me.
Well, I'm sorry. Please excuse me. I seem to have some very impatient customers. Now, how can I help? You look like a whiskey man.
Sure.
Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Sure. That's the real stuff. From Scotland.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Well, thank you.
So, mister, if I ask you a question, you ever hear of a fellow by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, friend.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, friend. You and your pal that was in here before.
Okay.
Bronte?
Angelo Bronte. Mr. Big. Mr. Italian spaghetti eating long streak of piss big. He makes my skin crawl. I'm so squally a cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
No.
Where can I find them? Oh, well, I reckon you talk to them kids in the alley. They'll know, I guess. Oh, hey, friend. You'll be careful now. Immigrants, they're not to be trusted.
Kids in the city are likely to run.
It's really become quite the craze.
So you just walk up to any man with a ring on his finger and turn it three times?
Yes. And then after 24 men, find any married person, male or female, wearing a wedding ring, turn that ring twice, and then the next man you shake hands with will become your husband.
What nonsense.
Yeah, that don't make sense at all.
Word for it then. You lost, mister?
Hi there. Have you seen any kids around here?
Oh, yeah. Just through that archway there.
Strange man with a rope hanging out. Are there any kids?
Hey.
Go up there.
You got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte. Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost.
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where does he live? New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. You don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
Oh, man. That's a bad breath. Here. Come on.
This way. Let's go, mister. You coming, Cleet? Stay close. Easy to get lost around here. Come on, then. You new to the city, mister?
Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Shriver on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My hey, kid.
They used to burn Protestants and all, but,
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, you little bit of shits!
Get going! He's coming after us!
Get back here!
Oh, you little fuck.
Stop, you shit.
You're making a fool of yourself.
You better stop right now.
Oh, what's up for my horse? What the fuck?
Ah, damn, street trash. You after that kid? That other shit went that way.
Thanks for the help, friend.
You know, I kind of miss him.
Hey, you see a kid about 14 years old run through here?
Why, yes, we did. He went around the corner there.
Thanks a lot, mister.
You better stop right now.
Run, damn it. Can I shoot him in the leg?
I'll spend it on something nice, mister, I promise.
You give that back!
What? Up and over, asshole, come on.
You all right back there, old man?
I'll kill you, even faster.
Give it up, farm boy.
Oh, come the fuck on. Move, motherfucker!
mister.
Morning. Why ain't I asking? Move, motherfuckers.
Fun, mister. I like you.
What the fuck? What the, how am I supposed to catch him?
What's the problem, friend?
Give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend, but that kid is. He robbed from me. Now, give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
The kid was gonna show me before he robbed me. Now, come on.
You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
You don't like no one, mister. Mr. Bronte, he's got fine hair. He got a beautiful house, and I am proud to work for him. He got 50 men, mister. Why are you gonna care a thing about you?
I just wanna speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He been mighty disrespected. Bunch of muddy Yankees in town asking questions. Well, you and your friends should pay him a visit, mister. He's got a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Hey, yokel.
Now, get out of here.
Oh, they didn't take my money. Huh. I'm actually impressed that they didn't steal the money. Look out. I'm guessing that's a cop.
Hey there.
Piece of shit horse.
Buenos dias, señor.
Yeah, la cucaracha.
Don't mind me.
Get out of the way. Where the fuck is this horse? Fucking hell, man. The hell, man.
Where have you been? Getting robbed?
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park. Huh.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John. You meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I can't believe they had the balls to actually take a kid from a group of outlaws.
I cannot decide which
a group of outlaws that sees himself as a family.
The swamps or the city.
Some balls of some great
both
stupidity.
Parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way east to land we know. Far from real open country.
Okay, hold on. I see another. What is this? Strangers? Oh, well, we're gonna do Dutch's first, since he's right here. Wait.
people wouldn't do that, you know?
Be there.
Move, bitch. No. Grab that. And we'll do that, and there we go. Need to up my stamina anyway. Might as well. And they spent some serious time in the country. I remember when Arthur's haircut and shit, so they've been here for a while. What's your gun? Cop or constable back in the day not carrying a gun? That's a good way to be an easy target. Go fuck yourself. What the hell? This is a long fucking way. Should have taken the horse. Look at you two old fucks sitting here at the park.
There you are. You boys ready?
Of course. What else do you know about this guy?
Not much, just that he's some slick little greasy-haired European. Clearly got power and money. Now,
listen.
If we go in there and start shooting up the place, the boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this? We're gonna have a lot of protection.
No one's gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm them. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John? I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen.
Huh. Run along now, boy.
Was that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax. I got this.
The hell? Should grab my shotgun. Is this really how slow you're gonna walk, Arthur?
Chi sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Who the fuck do you think you are?
Indeed you have. Now, We are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business.
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words. You lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Teodoro. That is the barest woman. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderlyn. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
It's an easy way to get shot. Come on.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know you would not want that, huh?
No.
No, no, no. So how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in this cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men, of course they run a mile, so maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, well, you tell me more about my manners. Salute.
Salute.
This is stupid. Oops. I want this.
Grave robbers? You think he's taking us for a fool?
No idea.
No, that's the squirrel shotgun. I want. There we go.
What choice do we have?
None. I guess.
I want the real shotgun. Idiotic. Fuck that squirrel shit.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know, you did good holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth?
Nope.
We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were going to hold Jack ransom for all the money we cost him. They must
probably
have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaites left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
I just hope you're right. Okay. I think this is it. Keep it down. Let's hitch your horses up ahead.
I'm trying to hitch my horse, and you're getting in the fucking way, moron.
Go on foot from here, Arthur.
Yeah, no shit, Sherlock. Okay. Don't want that. But I want this. Maintain. Clean. Let's clean this puppy up.
This way. Come on, coming. Let's find him and get the hell out of here.
Thank you. All right, so we're looking for grave robbers. It's a nice little setup. Maybe I should have grabbed my bow. Okay, I thought we were supposed to stop him. I thought it was going to a shootout. Okay, so let's try something else then. Let's get the boat. And if that doesn't work, then we're just supposed to catch them. See, he's got a rifle on his back. That's why I thought we were going for a shootout. Guess I was wrong.
What the hell? There's some damn birds. Come on. Come on. Let's find him and get the hell out of here. Someone's here somewhere. Come on. You hear something? Shush. Stop. Shush. Hold on. Wait a second.
Hey, nobody.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't care once we get the boy back.
That bastard better keep his word.
Get in cover, and we'll bust the door. Hey, John, over here.
You boys found my pappy's watching.
See? Go, Arthur. Jeez.
Bastards are trying to draw us out.
Nice shooting, Arthur. Can't see worth a damn.
Okay. See? I should have kept the shotgun.
No, let's find their stash. Gotta be around here someplace.
Okay.
Oh, your rifle.
We need to be quick.
We can't go back to Bronte empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time.
Okay. So...
something in here.
That's it?
Got it. Good. Now let's get out of here.
Shit, it's the law. Let's go. Maybe we can get out that gate. It's locked. We'll have to go back the way we came.
Damn it.
Come on. We best stick to the side.
I'm ready.
There's someone coming. Hide.
I found a body. Looks fresh. Still bleeding. Must just been killed. They're still here.
See, the bow comes in handy. That's just too much fun.
Come on, quick. Let's go back to Dutch.
You all right, girl?
I like using the slow time thing, but with the bow, that's pretty fun. Kids.
Like I said, just see where we're at once we got Jack.
It's just like,
all right, let's get this done.
What was the guy's name from Game of Thrones?
Come on, hey. Come on, Arthur.
I'm trying to get off the fucking horse, man. Get off the fuck. Jeez. Can you shut up for 3 seconds?
Let's go get Jack.
Yeah, I got a feeling this isn't gonna go our way.
Come on, let's get this over with.
Well, you took your time.
Jack, where's your host?
Ah. Like I said, you took your time.
Ah. I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend, thank Mr. Bronte for
right?
Everything.
Yeah, I'm fine. Come
on. For everything? What did he do?
Arthur, Mr. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house. And us, just simple country boys.
No, he's trying to get us as hired thugs. Come on.
Let's go. We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it.
Why are you guys this stupid? He's trying to use you as thugs.
Right. Let's get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
I'm sorry.
What for?
That for taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box and lots of books.
Did they do anything to you?
Have you ever had spaghetti?
What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte teaches me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo? That means and pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs, one for day and one for night.
Well, I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds like the kid was living the life.
Best time, but I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She sure did. Like you wouldn't know.
Real good to see you, Jack.
You too, Uncle Arthur. Did you catch the bad guys?
Which ones?
At the graveyard. Uncle Dutch and Papa Bronte told me.
Just Mr. Bronte.
Yeah. Me and your pa dealt with them.
I told him you would.
That's right.
Wait till you see this new camp.
Not another one.
Well, this one's got a house. Not as nice as Mr. Bronte's, mind you.
That's okay.
We'll get you settled and cleaned up in no time.
Oh, I had a bath last night.
Of course you did.
Sounds like the kid was having the time of his life. Although, you know, Italian, lots of guns. Has ears around the city. It sounds like the beginning of the mafia to me.
Everything.
We got him.
Mama.
He's fine.
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good. Italian. Did you ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch, Arthur, thank you. Thank you.
I never got those outfits / uniforms for kids. They always just look questionable.
Jack. How are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
So?
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys! We got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well, the boy's safe, thank goodness.
Thank you, Arthur. I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
I need a haircut. Why didn't we move into the house?
Hey, make some room for John there.
Come on, are we celebrating?
Where's my tent? Camp party? Provisions, drinking, butcher, drinking, grub, health. Oh. Am I supposed to join the party? Let me I need some stew.
Se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca. No se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca.
Ay, 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 ay.
Canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo los corazones.
Not my scene, guys.
Sadie?
Sure. You boys did good.
Well, we got lucky this time.
Let me get you something. Thanks, Mama. Can I play a little?
One of these days we'll get you singing.
You don't want to hear that, I promise.
Oh, but I do, Herr Strauss.
Yeah, probably not. Okay, is there something I can do while they're doing this shit? I'd like to make it daytime, you know what I mean? This fog is a bitch.
If you say so. Mangoes, maidens, paradise, an unspoiled paradise.
Yeah, I hope so.
Faith, Arthur. Have a little faith. Okay, I'll catch you later then. All right, Arthur.
Yum, 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 yum. Yeah, well, shit happens. Gotta get daytime, got shit to do. Oh, no, 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 no. Fast travel. Oh, yeah, give me that ammo. There we go. How do I... I can't trim his hair. Okay.
Nobody ever gonna take him again, I swear.
Yeah, we'll do morning. It's only 3 hours, but you know, sleep. What do you mean you weren't all together? What the fuck? Trying to pick up that letter. Oh, there we go.
My dear Arthur, I hope this letter finds you well. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand that Jamie is thinking about going back to college. Whatever happens, I believe you saved his life, and we are all truly grateful. Oh, Arthur, I have made such a mess of my life, time and again. Why can I not change and be the woman I want to be? Why couldn't you change and be a man and put down all those fantasies that shroud your judgment? Life is very confusing, and I see now that I am not very good at it.
Nobody really is.
I'm afraid we've got ourselves into another mess.
Are you fucking me?
Not my fault, but I need your help. I'm staying at the Hotel Grand in Saint Denis. Oh, Arthur, I know it is wrong to ask you, but I have nobody else, and for what we once had together, I beg of you, even though I am ashamed to do so. Yours, Mary.
First of all, are you mine? Because you did say yours. Man, he's down bad. If she... Yeah. Wait. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna change our clothing here. Really? Just change his hats? Have a big ugly hat, but fits with the outfit. All right, let's see how far we're going. All right, we're gonna fast travel to Saint Denis if I can. I like this fast travel thing too, where you get to see like other parts of the map. It's not just like a loading screen or anything stupid. Jeez. Get that camera back where it's supposed to be, man. Alright, we're gonna mark it. There we go. Safety in nature. Oh, great. Tree huggers. Move, people. This is a roadway, not a walkway. They're out in the middle of the fucking road, man.
Joseph.
Arthur! Arthur!
What the fuck? Oh.
You came!
Yeah. I came. So, what do you need?
Wait there. I'm coming straight down.
Nosy ass people. Really?
Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I'll come.
Really?
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
Well, I gotta save her dad now?
I know Daddy was not kind to you, but... But surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Than the choices you make.
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... Well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you and Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
Sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else.
Probably a good idea.
But I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that. Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy?
Why not? Because it's a quest.
Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur. You know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling, and drinking, and other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose really? I can take some consolation in that.
No, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But, well, I don't know.
Just like a woman can't get out a full fucking sentence while being cryptic as shit.
So what do you think he's up to?
I'm not sure. He keeps saying it's a disgrace a man of his standing has to ride around
really?
On some old nag.
Standing? He's usually falling down.
Arthur...
Hey, if it's the truth,
this way, but it has got worse. He's drinking and gambling more than ever, pawning things off left and right, mixing with bad people.
Sounds like he's in debt.
For him.
Don't worry too much. Whatever it is, we'll work it out.
This is the place. Why are you being so strange?
I'm waiting on your ass. Come on.
Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck.
I got a feeling I'm going to be needed.
Very funny.
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. She's a fine lady. She's just gone inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you. And make my apologies to the lady. It's your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
Never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait, daughter. Right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy.
No.
Oh, Daddy, wow. Please, come home. You're tired, Daddy. Tired and
I have no
unwell.
Such thing. You get away from me. You head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, I see.
Oh, Arthur. He's up to no good. We better follow him.
Okay.
Why do I got a feeling?
This way. He went around the corner.
No shit. I can see shit. Ugh, lady. I ain't blind.
Hold up, Arthur.
You can see why he has such a high opinion of himself. He'll just follow the smell.
Arthur. Come on.
It's true.
He just went between those crates.
You think?
Come here. Quick.
Mind where you go. Mind where you go.
Uh-oh.
Sorry?
Do you think he saw us?
I don't think so.
What did you say to me?
I didn't say a thing insulting.
I'll wipe that goddamn smirk clean off your face.
Ain't you a little old for brawling, mister?
Damn you! Hello?
He's heading across the road.
Nope. This is kind of fun.
Shh. He'll hear you. You could have cleaned yourself up a bit.
I didn't realize
I was gonna impress anyone. I don't think he really cares about hearing us. He went around the corner.
Down that alleyway.
Yeah, I know.
What's he doing?
Let's go find out.
Wait, Arthur. Any closer and he'll spot us.
Well, get behind some, bitch. I'm the one that's hiding behind shit and you're just standing out in the open. Who's gonna recognize more, me or his daughter?
What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Here.
Here's the money. Oh, that is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money. And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not even his to sell.
No, it's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
Yeah, I make no promises. Probably.
Hey, you, Ashton, hold her right there.
Yo, what the fuck? Where's my horse? You're just gonna fucking...
Yep.
Yo, go, you stupid fucking horse. Ah, we might want to keep her gun away. We'll grab the rope, though.
Get back here. Yeah, you stop right now.
That didn't work. I can't shoot the horses. Okay. I can't grab one of them either? Okay, so what the fuck? Well, I'm not trying to save. They're supposed to follow it? Told you to stop it.
This is insane.
Does he know or? Get the fuck out.
Wasn't Gillis's to sell.
I bought it fair and square.
I'm taking
it. What do you want for it?
I guess I could give it to you for $100.
$100? What do you take me for?
Okay, okay. I'm a reasonable man. Let's say 50.
Not good enough, Ashton.
Okay, Jesus. $25, that's my final offer.
Give me the brooch.
Take the damn thing. You crazy son of a bitch. You don't know who you're messing with.
That. Just ran a piece of shit. Because he said he knows what happens to other people when they take a loan, so he had that coming.
Yeah.
What am I gonna fast track? Oh, hey, looky there. She's gonna find out I shot him though, huh?
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Well, let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Got you your brooch back.
Don't ask how. Good.
Probably best not.
Hey, what are you doing now, right this moment?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I I was wondering if you wanted to do something. Head to the theater, perhaps.
Oh, man, this better be good.
Theater? Me? Sure, why not?
It'll be fun, Arthur. Let's go to the Relure. They have the strangest acts.
Strangeness I can handle. Well, it's the normal business of life. I can't seem to get a grip on.
You and me both, Arthur. Oh, I've missed you.
Don't start.
You're an idiot. But you'll always be my friend.
Well, of course I'm your friend, but you ain't always fair with me.
If I was fair with you and a good person, I'd have had you hanged a long time ago.
Well, that's true.
So, shut up and act like a gentleman, or at least try to for once in your brainless life.
You're not brainless?
A very nice woman, Mrs. Lamb.
Well, look at the company I keep.
I know, it's quite dreadful, isn't it?
Sort of beautiful. In a gaudy and tasteless way.
It's the only way I know.
Thank you.
Oh, no, I didn't mean it like that.
I'm sure. You silly man. Come on.
One ticket.
Let's go find our seats.
I got a feeling I'm going to hate this.
How about here on the right?
Sure.
After you.
Oh, man, they're going to make me sit through this?
Welcome! And thank you for that thunderous applause. I am Aldridge T. Abington, the greatest assembler of entertainment since Nero himself. Do not doubt. As a child, when I walked the horse manure covered streets of Saint-Denis, I never dreamed of the stir I would create in this locality.
Just starting or not?
Are you in a rush,
Arthur?
Of
the greatest show ever assembled. Prepare for the grandest excitement of your curiosity.
Something's got to happen here.
Fire, snakes, and magic. I encourage any of you to dabble in all three if you have a settled aversion to manual labor as I do. For entertainment is a gift that will see you through the winter better than any packed larder or root cellar full of canned goods.
Bullshit.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a truly stunning musical performance to the stage, Miss Robin Koninsky.
What was the name of the other chick that was, couldn't sing worth a shit.
Thank you for joining us. Now let's talk a little bit about this place we all love called Saint-Denis.
I swear if she starts yodeling, I'm out.
They come from Road Strawberry and Valentine, singing a song and drinking wine, across Bayou Swamp and over the sea,
we're heading
down to Saint-Denis. If your wagon is broke, get to the blacksmith shop. Don't worry yourself with planting a crop. The girls are wearing a brand new gown. And let off that yoke. Pretty young things say, come with me in the parlors and brothels of Saint-Denis. The porter is drinking and the whistle just blew. The trains are heading to the land of voodoo. You won't sleep a wink, I can guarantee. Let's go drinking down in Saint-Denis.
Not as bad as I thought it was going to be. That's for damn sure.
Saloon, the rich and poor and the bougie.
I did not hit the chair or nothing. My hands are free. So is this a full-fledged thing?
Perfect. Oh, I see you. You love her dulcet tones, right? Yes, she is pure spectacle, and I assure you she can charm any beast at all, from cockroach to killer whale. Your mother most likely told you not to play with fire, or to spend time in the company of strange women. You are about to do both. Miss Antoinette Sansovino.
Stop it. Wonderful.
Those candles. Oh, I was wondering what that was around her waist.
You can see how this could go horribly wrong.
I hope she stays away from the curtain.
Well, hopefully she's practiced, so she shouldn't get told anew about it. All right, well, this is old already. She's doing the same thing over and over again. I'm gonna look up how long this thing is. Half hour.
Enchanting, mesmerizing. She is truly one to bring home to mother. It is said that there is a place in France where the naked ladies dance.
Okay, so there's supposed to be like one more. So there's like three acts.
Body brassiers of the Petit Flaneur in Gay Paris.
So this should be it. Says it takes like a half hour though. Thank you. Hey, people said to take their time with the game and enjoy all of it, right? Pennywise shit right there. How much shit you think a guy like this would get back in the day for doing this theater stuff? The Pennywise dance. Is that a theater thing back in the day? That was a long ending segment for any theater performance. And music started to stop, and then it kept going for like an additional 20 seconds. Okay, Google said 3X. That was 3.
Behold, I am spent. Each of my shows is truly incredulous, awe-inspiring, and I'm sure you enjoyed. Thank you. We flounder through the morass of humanity with only bright moments like these before it all goes dim and snuffs out in silence. So thank you. What a lovely evening. Come back tomorrow.
Why?
All right. Well, shall we?
Yes. That was fun, Arthur.
It was.
If you say so.
All right. You better take me to the trolley now, Mr. Morgan.
Of course.
Quite ridiculous. But somehow very amusing.
Sure.
My life wasn't supposed to... Oh. Is it too late for us, Arthur?
That took a turn.
I can't lie to you. I'm a wanted man, Mary. If anyone close to me, well, they're wanted to. Can't have you wrapped up in there. But it's coming to an end. This time it really is.
Run away with me, Arthur. Run away right now and don't look back.
I want to. More than anything, I want to. But I've got some people I need to take care of. Once they're free, then I'm free. Then I can disappear.
But Arthur...
If we're gonna run away anywhere, we'd need money. Soon. Have some.
I know you won't run away. But it's a pretty dream.
Very pretty. But I will, once I get some money. I had some, but then some fool got it trapped into a town that I can't go back to. It's another story.
I'll write you.
How do letters keep finding their way if the gang keeps moving around? That's one thing I don't get. Stop with this camera shit. That's the spot I like. Thank you. All right. Oh, yeah. I want my horse. Give me my horse. Oh, yeah. I don't know why I didn't, Oh, my horse. Is that far away? What is this? Fuck it. We'll see what Strauss wants.
Hello, sir.
Try meeting our horse. Why is it always foggy here? Dude.
What you think?
Easy there.
I'll get off the road.
Howdy, sir.
Come the fuck on. Are you serious? Thank God.
Okay, girl.
All right, let's get going.
Hey.
Move, bitch. To ask like that.
Get yourself some real food, huh?
Listen, you have to take this.
Ooh, that's real kind of you.
I lost my money playing poker.
Mate, that'll increase my health? Oh shit. Hell yeah. Shit, if I had known that, I'd been looking for the stuff. What is it with people and like riding horses in this bitch? What the fuck they're doing? Place is foggy shit. Taking a while. Good thing this game looks good with how much travel time you gotta do. That snapping turtle. Is that a goat? How about we get out of the water? Alright. I'm going to end this here, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you like, you comment, subscribe. Thank you, anybody who's watched up to this point. Trying to get to that 500 by the end of the year. I think we can do it, and I'll catch you later.